Myself, Mohammad Imrani, Assistant Professor of Commerce Computer Application, Islamia College Autonomous, Vanambadi. Today we discuss about basic fundamentals of accounting, business transaction entries and as well as journal entries. Today we shall discuss about in basic fundamentals of accounting. The basic fundamentals of accounting, the knowledge about accounting information, accounting backgrounds, everything should be learned today. So today we shall discuss first introduction. Introduction. In accounting, various authors, various definitions says, but in standard definition, accounting is a art of recording. Accounting is a art of recording, summarizing, classifying, and in a significant manner of in terms of money. First, the one by one we have to discuss. What is recording? Recording is a basic as well as important, the backbone of accounting. Recording is a each and every business transaction should be recorded, because recording is a very important role in accounting process, in accounting to prepare any accounts, either the trial balance, journal, ledger, even final account also. Without recording, you cannot prepare anything, because recording is a first and foremost step in accounting. In recording, first we shall discuss in recording. Recording is a business transaction. Daily the business transaction should be running, that you have to record. That is called a recording of business transaction. It is also known as the art of recording. Art of recording. Then next, journalizing. And next, ledger. First one is the basic introduction, the basic important things: recording, journalizing, ledger, and trial balance. So recording as well as in few recording, already told you what is record and what are the types of recording in business transaction. Then go for next one is a journalizing. What is journal? Journal is a French word. The French word is jour, J-O-U-R, jour. Jour means day-to-day expenses you have to record. That is called a journalizing. What is journalizing means? Journalizing is nothing but a journal. Journal is the actual name, is called a French word. The name should came in French word, jour, J-O-U-R, jour. Journal, French word jour means day-to-day expenses you have to record. Day-to-day expenses, you are recording in a day-to-day expenses. And another important things in journalizing, journal is a first and foremost entry in accounting. First and foremost entry in accounting. The first step in accounting, journalizing. Because the journalizing has the separation may be given. What is the debit entry and what is the credit entry? And then given a narration also. The question may be the debit as well as a credit entry. For example, I told you paid wages. As example in journal entry, paid wages. What is wages? Wages is different, salary is different. Because salary means monthly receiving a money is called a monthly receiving of money is called a salaries, earning, either halfly, quarterly, depends on organizations. But wages is a daily payment. There is a two differences between wages and salaries. Wages is a daily payment, salary is a monthly payment. So what is wages? Paid wages. How to framing a journal entry? Before go through the journal entries in explanation of the what is wages means. The paid wages within the entry, one is a debit and another credit is also there in the paid wages. How they may be here. First, for example, what is paid wages? Paid wages means wages account debtor to cash account. There is a two things is there. Paid wages means wages account debtor to cash account. One is a debit, another is a credit is there. So wages account means those who are receiving money is called a debit side. Those who are giver, for example, the cash may be given means the cash will be a credited. Your amount has been credited, your amount should be a deducted. So wages account data to cash accounts. Then there is an example maybe in a journal entry. And another, journal entry is a first and foremost entry. Journal is a original entry. First entry, primary entry. That is called a journal entry. Journal entry is a another chronicle order you have to prepare. You need not for as your wish, you need not to prepare. Based on your records, based on the order, based on the date, you have to prepare. For example, 1st April, almost in accounting means 1st April to start and 31st March may be closing in accounting year. One is a calendar year, another is a accounting year is there. But in accounting follow only accounting year, 1st April to start and 31st March. Based on this accounting year, you have to prepare your data. For example, 1st April 2018, business start with a capital. The entry you have to record, original entry, primary entry, first entry, as per a chronicle order also. And then you have to prepare for what is the framework of a journal. Date, particulars and rupees column. First, we shall elaborately discuss what is journal and how to framing a journal. If the question may be given means what is the debit entry, what is the credit entry, we shall discuss and elaborately. First one is a journal format. The heading may be given a journal format. One is a date column. Date is very important in accounting. Either for example, the personal, real, nominal, whatever you have to understand. But date is very important. Without date, you cannot prepare anything. And next one is a particulars. Particulars means either the wages, salary, either the cash receiver or cash giver. And next one is a rupees column. Rupees is nothing but amount column. What is the debit amount? And date column, particular column, rupees column. One is a two side, another is a by side entries you have to frame it. For example, there is a format of a journal entry. If I write it one question, based on the question you have to frame it. Question number one, journal entry, first journalize the following transactions. Journalize the following transaction means you have to prepare a journal entry. The question may be given a transaction entry. The first transaction entry as per a date wise, for example, 1-4-2018. Day, month, year is very important in accounting. Day, month and year.
First entry, business start, business start with a capital of rupees 5 lakh. Just
business first entry, business start with a capital of rupees 5 lakh. The next entry,
2/4/2018, cash deposited with ICICI rupees 2 lakh.
Then next year,
5/4/2018, purchased machinery rupees 50,000,
purchased machinery rupees 50,000. Next
example, 8/4/2018, cash piled to Nihal rupees 25,000.
So almost 4 journal entry. And next year,
for example, 10/4/2018, paid salaries rupees 10,000.
Just a few examples, because you have to understand what is the debit entry, what is the credit entry, how to framing all those, these entries, very important. First one, accounting year may be given, accounting year, not in calendar year, because 1/4 starts on accounting year. Calendar year means January 1st to start and 31st December may be closed. If you accounting year mean 1st April to start and 31st March closing of the account. 1/4/2018, business start with a capital of rupees 5 lakh. What is the entry now? Next, 2/4/2018, cash deposit with ICICI bank rupees 2 lakh. Next entry, 5/4/2018, purchase machinery rupees 50,000. And next journal, and the next date, 8/4/2018, cash paid to Nihal rupees 25,000. Next, 10/4/2018, paid salary rupees 10,000. How to framing these journal entries? Very simple. First, one by one you have to discuss.
One is a date column. Next one is a particular column. And next, a rupees column. One is a debit column as well as a credit also. Date, particulars, debit rupees, credit rupees.
Understand? Date column, particular column, debit rupees column, credit rupees column. The first entry,
1/4/2018,
business start with a capital of rupees 5 lakh. What is the entry now? Cash account data to capital account. Because business, if you invest your money, invest your cash, there is actual 3 types of accounting. One is a personal account, real account, nominal account. Personal means there is a 2 type of, artificial and natural. Next one is a impersonal account, means a real account, nominal account. Real account is nothing but in connected on balance sheet purely. And nominal account means P&L account, either profit or loss account you have to prepare. So before go through this, the first business start with a capital of rupees 5 lakh. The first entry,
cash account data rupees 5 lakh to capital account 5 lakh rupees. narration being business start being business start, business start with capital, rupees sum of 1 lakh rupees, 5 lakh rupees.
So cash account data to capital account. The separate the entry in single entry, business transaction, the transaction entry is a recording entry, the transaction entry should be separate with which is the debit entry, which is the credit entry. Cash account data, you are receiving of a money, rupees 5 lakh rupees debit in your account. To capital, the company has been investment. So to capital of rupees 5 lakh rupees. Separate debit entry, separate credit entry should be mentioned. And next, 2/4/2018. Next, cash deposit with ICIC Bank. An example, cash deposit, who is the giver, who is the receiver? First you have to understand, because who is the giver, debit the receiver, credit the giver, debit and credit both are equal amount. If you understand, cash account data 5 lakh rupees, cash account data 5 lakh rupees, to capital account 5 lakh rupees, both the entries, both the amount, debit as well as credit, both amount should be equal. Debit is equal to credit, debit is equal to credit, and credit is equal to debit. So both side of the amount should be equal, not in imbalance of amount. There is a balance of amount. Debit is equal to credit and credit is equal to debit. So next one is, so debit also 5 lakh rupees, credit also 5 lakh rupees. So both amount should be equal. For example, if you debit in 5 lakh rupees, credit in 4,50,000, means the journal entry may be given a reflections. Remaining the balance of 50,000 should be a reflection amount, imbalance amount. So you can't adjustment it. Next, cash deposit with ICICI Bank 2 lakh rupees. Who is a giver and who is a receiver? Banker risk. Cash deposit with ICICI. So who is a receiver? Banker is a receiver. Who is a giver? The company has a giver. You, if you deposit your money, means you are a giver. Those who are receiver is called a creditor. For example, cash deposit with ICICI Bank. So ICICI Bank, because bank is a receiver. Bank is a receiver. And who is the giver? What is, who is the giver means to cash account, to cash account. For example, if the company has given name, means you record a company name. For example, ABC Company Limited, deposit a sum of rupees 5 lakh, 10 lakh, 20 lakhs, depends on your transaction entries. Oh, ICICI Bank account data 2 lakh rupees. ICICI Bank is a receiver, receiving of a money, receiving of a cash. So receiver side, debit the receiver, credit the giver. Suppose if you visit your nearest bank, your same account, in your account, SB account, if you deposit a sum of 5,000 rupees, 5,000 rupees you have to deposit in your account. So who is a giver and who is a receiver? You are a giver, because your account has been in your bank. So you have to go and visit and write your challan, deposit challan. For example, 5,000 rupees in your account number should be written, name, everything. If you may be giver to the clerk or concerned account officer, the banker has a receiver, the concerned party has a receiver, the banker is a receiver, you are a giver. So you are a creditor, and those who are receiver is called a debtor. One is a debit, another is a credit. Debit is equal to credit and credit is equal to debit. Suppose if you verify in your account, the same amount will be a deposit in your account, 5,000 rupees. Your receipt is also mentioned in 5,000 rupees, your receipt is there. So in the same connection, ICICI Bank account data to cash account. Next, the next journal entry. Date, particulars, and rupees column. Next, purchase machinery rupees 50,000 rupees. The next date, 5/4/2018. Purchase machinery means, purchase is always debit side, sale is always credit side. So purchase machinery account data
purchased machinery account to cash account. On which basis?
Either the cash basis or credit basis also purchasing. Sometimes not only, in always all the business should be purchased on a cash basis, not only. Cash as well as a credit. If in accounting, cash as well as a credit also. So purchased machinery, who is a purchaser? The concerned party, the concerned company has purchasing a machine. Purchased machine. Purchase is always a debit side and sale is always a credit side. Purchased machinery account data, how much of amount? Just 50,000 of machinery should be purchased. The same machinery value should be credited. The same concern amount should be credited in your account. So purchased machinery account data to cash account. Being machine purchased. Being machine purchased. Being machine purchased. Next entry. Cash paid to Nihal. Cash paid to Nihal. So cash paid to Nihal. Understand. Cash paid to Nihal. So who is a giver and who is a receiver? You are, for example, I am a giver. Nihal is a receiver. I am a giver means I am a credit point. And those who are receiver is called a debit side. So Nihal is a receiver. Nihal account data to cash account. So amount may be on 25,000. 25,000. Being cash paid. Being cash paid. So there is a very important journal entry. Today we shall discuss about a few glimpses of a 5 entries only. One is a business start with a capital, cash deposit, cab machine purchased and cash paid. And last one is a 10th 4 2018 salary paid. Salary paid. Because if you are employer, I am a employer means my company, in my own organization, under working in our employee. So employee may be given a salary. Before at the initial stage in episode, I already told you the difference between the wages and salary. Because wages is a different concept, salary is a different concept. So paid salaries means the concerned employee has receiving some money, earning at the end of a month. Those who are receiving is always a debit side. Under the golden rules of accounting, one is a personal account, debit the receiver, credit the giver. Under the nominal account is nothing but profit or loss account, profit or loss account. Debit what comes in, credit what goes out. Under the nominal account, debit all expenses, credit all gains. And last one is a real account. What are the real accounts? Real account is nothing but a assets account. Debit what comes in, credit what goes out. Under nominal account, the journal entry should be framed paid salaries account. Salary account data. Salary account data to cash account. To cash account. The amount may be given on 10,000. The amount may be given on 10,000. 10,000. So being salary paid. Salary paid. There is a 5 journal entries, the important journal entries. So today we shall discuss in our first episode the basic fundamentals of accounting, introduction, and next one is a recording of business transaction. The business transaction, recording of business transaction, first step. Because recording is an art. Recording is in a art. The recording of business transaction entry. Business start with the capital is a recording of business transaction. The business transaction entry should be the next entry, journal entry. Journal already discussed in a, what is journal mean? Journal is a French word. Everything should be discussed in our episodes. So how to framing a journal entry? Because the first and foremost accounting cycle after the transaction, journal entry is very important. First entry, original entry and primary entry as per the chronicle order wise. Format already I discuss in our episodes, and then for the problem and the question as well as a problem also discuss. So thank you for listening and watching from my video. Please subscribe our channel also. Thank you.